The British Virgin Islands recently celebrated Territory Day, the commencement of the handling of its own affairs on July 1, 1956. Soon thereafter followed the ministerial system of governance.
Minister of Education and Culture Myron Walwyn said that Territory Day is a symbol of great pride for Virgin Islanders as it comes closest to an independence observation for the former British colony. It is for this reason that Minister Walwyn took issue with the recent exercising of constitutional powers by outgoing Governor John Duncan, which he argued took the BVI back to a period in its history it would rather leave in the past.
The recent actions of the Governor to invoke Section 103 of the Constitution was met by contempt by many persons who know the struggles and triumphs of our country. There is no question that the Governor has the right in the Constitution to invoke the section, but it offended the pride of our people. It took us back for a moment to a place that we have long passed and have no interest in returning to, however well-intentioned his actions were.
Earlier this year, Minister Walwyn took the Governor to task for comments publicly criticizing the Dr. D. Orlando Smith administration, reminding the Governor that the territory has made great strides as a new democracy and highlighting that while there is more to be done, significant progress has been made in the area of good governance and accountability since Governor Duncan's appointment. In that scathing critique, the Governor questioned the administration's allocation of monetary resources while seeming to place more emphasis on its international rather than local courts and the police force. Governor Duncan asserted that there were several pieces of legislation which are yet to be enacted but which would be critical to Britain entertaining any talks of a political separation, including the Freedom of Information Act, whistleblower legislation, and a Human Rights Commission. Meanwhile, Minister Walwyn, in his Territory Day address, asserted that the BVI must build on the foundation laid by its forefathers in forging a stronger and more resilient people and country, which was initially left to become a bird sanctuary.
We have handled the affairs of our territory very well since 1967. We have not been perfect, and indeed no country is perfect, even those that may think that they are perfect. There are things that we still must do, and we need to get on with them. But there has been steady growth in the handling of our economy and many areas since we've had greater autonomy. We were able, through the leadership of our people, to develop an impressive road network system territory-wide. We were able to develop our telecommunication systems, which we were able to connect us to different parts of the territory and to anywhere in the world. We were able to develop a modern electricity system. We were able to have free education now up to the tertiary level. We were able to develop our health and social services system that provide a safety net for our people. We were able to develop a vibrant financial services sector and an excellent tourism product. This year's US News and World Report named the BVI as the number one place for vacation in the Caribbean. The recent report entitled Creating Value, the BVI's Global Contribution, revealed that our tiny country enables global investment and trade that supports more than 2 million jobs worldwide and contributes more than $15 billion in tax revenues annually for governments around the world. Ladies and gentlemen, we have come a very long way since 1967, and we should be very proud. I am proud to say what a wonderful bird sanctuary we have now.
This year's Territorial Day activities were observed under the theme Territorial Awakening, Resilience in a Time of Challenge and Change.